Hello, malty malt lumps. Ralphie here, and back in the studio for the first time in a little while. Summer is here in Scotland, so it's a good time to get out and about. But one of the disadvantages of being on windswept mountain tops or in whiskey premises, shops and off sales and distilleries is that you can't really pin down detail about a single malt because of the distractions around you, which is perfectly understandable. So because I'm doing a little run of videos on Ochentoshan, which is very typical of a lowland distillery, I'd like to use the studio time to kind of go into a wee bit more depth about the whisky. And here's the whisky. Ochentoshan, 12-year-old. Just recently done a video showing the single cask in warehouses and saying a little bit about it. And what I'd like to say first and foremost is that it is such a shame that lowland whiskies tend to get dismissed by whisky buffs and whisky connoisseurs as being suitable for beginners because they're light and sweet. It's missing an awful lot about lowland whiskies. The main lowland whiskies available tend to be Glenkinchie over in outside Edinburgh, which is very much sweetie shop lowland malt whisky. That's what you get in the nose and the taste. Bladnach, which is going through a tremendous renaissance at the moment under the Armstrong family. And of course, Ochentoshan here, which is a very good example of a triple distilled whisky. In fact, you can see possibly on the glass there on the bottle, your three stills together. And it says it on the label too. Certainly good packaging. They recently repackaged everything at Ochentoshan. So you've got a practical, sensible cardboard box, nice tasteful grey colouring, a little bit of texture to the packaging, and a nice shaped bottle. One thing that puts me off a little bit in this branding is there has been caramel added, E150A, to the whisky, and it's not doing it any favours. However, it's early days yet, and I do believe that distillers at some point will ease off the caramel and ease off the chill filtration and increase their sales, just like Highland Park are doing. So, a little bit more about the lowland distilleries. There are three out there that I've mentioned. There are also another three which are no longer in production. They've closed down, Linlithgow, Rosebank and Littlemill. If you see these bottles out there, you might like to buy one either to keep as a collector's item or to enjoy later when the prices are rocketing. Another feature of Ochentoshan is, although it's a lowland distillery, it actually has a highland water source coming down from the Kilpatrick Hills, interestingly enough, passing by a crematorium on the way, another point of notice, and a cemetery, which we can have a wee laugh about, but that's well away from the distillery itself, the other side of a main road. And is also found popping up in Ballantine's blended whisky. Now, I recommend the 12-year-old because at 12 years, you're getting away from the real youthfulness of Ochentoshan, which tends to be fairly two-dimensional, fresh, zesty, with a little bit of syrup. I'll pour myself a glass of this. That's quite enough. And I have taken Ralphie notes. I don't tend to take too many notes, but just out of interest, if you're taking notes yourself, really just divide it into the nose and the taste, a wee bit about the colour of the whisky, whether you notice E150 has been added to which will affect it, and whether you're going to leave it, the amount of time you leave it before it really starts to kind of open up as a whisky, and just how much water you've added to the whisky, which was really ideal for yourself. So, Ralphie's notes.
Right.
Ochintoshan 12-year-old on the nose. Quite zesty. Honey malt. Fresh honey malt. A touch of white pepper. There is bitterness and dry wood on the nose. And I think there's gone quite a lot of refill bourbon casks. I also suspect a lot of recharring of the cask has been going on. Casks have been going on before the whiskey was placed into them. And the certain smoke and ashiness is coming through. It doesn't do any harm at all. Angelica, cardamom, the spice. There's a Glenfiddichy green appleness about this. And a herbal vanilla. And I conclude, once you've been sniffing it for a wee while, a touch of condensed milk. Unusual, that one, but there we go. Adding water, it's already down to 40%. I recommend that you do not add much water at all. Just a wee drop out of the pouring jug. Get a broad spout rather than a narrow spout, because it's easier to control the pour. Right, taste-wise. Quite sharp. And the bitter and smokiness comes through as well. I'm getting a marzipan syrup, malty, sweet malt, grainish, bitter oak and smoke. Now, I mentioned Lapsang Souchong, the tea. And I got an email about that saying, Ralphie, that's a strong, strong tea. How can you use that to describe what is like a light whiskey and light flavours? But within these light flavours, there is that ash, there is that bitterness and that smoke. And those are features of Lapsang Souchong tea. So that's why I mentioned that one. And sour lemon and old sweetie shops from when you get sweeties out of jars rather than packets. Now, I poured Ochintoshan earlier. And the reason for that is because, take my word for it, 15 minutes later after you've poured this whiskey, you will get something else, in a significant evolution in the flavour. This whisky needs time to get over that E150 obstacle and really start to express itself, let out its freshness and its lovely summery citrusy notes. Again, it's quite complex with that smokiness, the ashiness, the... And to conclude, marks out of 100, I'm going to give 83 out of 100. Now, this would have been 86, easy, if it wasn't for being so branded with the E150. Frankly, I think with a little more attention to detail, upping the strength a little bit, a little more cask care, you're looking at heading into the 90s. An intriguing, beguiling, engaging whisky, which is just... got so much to offer if given the chance. And I'll summarise, conclude, as time's marching on here, by saying that I've mentioned Celtic Connection whiskies before. Again, you can do a Celtic Connection with Ochintoshan. Just a wee drop, a Black Bush, Bushmills, Jameson's, Cooley, just a tiny wee drop into that whisky. Right? Give it a few minutes and you're going to get two whiskies put together that become so more than the sum of their parts, because they're so, so related. And to conclude, Ochintoshan triple distilled. There'll be a video coming up shortly, video probably number 6162, which will kind of go into detail. But there's only two distilleries in Scotland that triple distill, Springbank, but more importantly, Ochintoshan, because they're triple distilling all the time. Right, all done. If you want to know more, Ralphie.com. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again shortly. As long as you're watching the videos, I'll be producing the videos.